If at any point someone asked you, which animal is more dangerous, the hippo or the lion, your answer would undoubtedly be lions. They are, after all, kings of the jungle and absolute beasts in their own right. But what if we told you that more people die by hippo attacks in a year than lion attacks? That's right. Let's look at some statistics, shall we? Sharks, one of the deadliest creatures on the planet, kill only 10 people a year. That's right. If jaws scare you, you're going to be terrified of hippos after this video. And while lions and elephants kill about 100 people a year, hippos kill a whopping 500 per year. These seemingly chill, docile creatures have an aggressive side to them you should hope to never see. These tourists seem to be just driving about on a safari when they see a hippo tailing them from a distance. Their jeep is still as the hippo approaches, and these guys should definitely be more scared than they look. Look at how fast the jeep is going, but the hippo surprisingly gets quite close. It gives up the chase quite quickly, and the tourists get away. But what would have happened if they were caught? A boat of students in West Africa on their way to school sure found out. Children in this region often take boats to and from school, and this particular boat had 12 students. As they were making their way, a hippo spotted them, and probably wasn't too pleased about them encroaching on his territory. So how does an animal like the hippo respond to such a heinous act of trespassing? Well, stick around to find out. These mammals weigh between 1.5 and 4 tons and grow up to 14 feet long. They spend 16 hours in the water each day, lumbering along the bottom of rivers and lakes in sub-Saharan Africa, with only their eyes and nostrils peeking out above the surf. And though they move pretty easily through the water, they can't actually swim. Instead, they just glide through the water by pushing themselves off other objects. And that's pretty much how we learn ice skating. Hippos eat only plants, about 80 pounds each day. But they're still one of the most aggressive animals on Earth. In fact, they can snap a canoe in half with their powerful jaws. With that kind of power, no hippo is going to fear a lion. Not that it's easy to injure one. You'd need a rocket launcher to penetrate that skin. Punching them is like trying to take down Colossus from Deadpool. They're just going to stand there, unbothered by you. They've been known to soak up entire clips of machine gun fire without any serious injuries. The average hippo is covered with 4 centimeter thick skin that weighs about a ton, which is about the weight of a car without wheels or engine. There's no creature in the jungle that could hurt or kill the hippo, other than perhaps another hippo. Yep, that includes sharks and crocodiles. In fact, a hippo's teeth can pierce right through a crocodile. Check out this guy, grabbing a croc by his tail and whipping him around. And this croc just seems to be having the absolute worst day of his life. So as crazy as it is, these vegetarian giants sit atop the food chain in Africa, capable of even killing apex predators for seemingly no reason. Just check out what happens when this lion, who just needed some water, roamed into hippo territory. But there's being territorial, and then there's invading. When Pablo Escobar imported hippos to his private zoo, he essentially created an ecological time bomb. After Escobar was killed, all his animals were shipped off to different zoos, but the hippos were left there. Back then, there were 3 females and 1 male. Today, there's about 80 to 120 of them roaming about, and the numbers will continue climbing. Why not? They have no predators, and no humans could poach them even if they wanted to. They're free to do as they like. Hippos live in sub-Saharan Africa, in areas with abundant water. They need it, since they spend most of their time submerged to keep their skin cool and moist. Their large teeth and tusks help them fight off threats, even if that threat is humans or their own kind. Sometimes, young hippos will fall victim to an adult's bad temper. They might get whacked for misbehaving, as is the case with us monkeys, or get caught between 2 adults fighting. In some cases, male hippos will straight up attack a younger male hippo to cut out competition. Here, the dominant male launches an attack, and the baby starts swimming for its life. The large male manages to grab the infant in its mouth, give it a good shake, and it was all over in seconds. It was brief and brutal. As shocking as that is, it's pretty common in the animal kingdom for adults to devour or kill their young, especially if it's young males. Some even eat their young if there's a struggle for food. It's a common thing with big cats especially. Wish we could say things are relatively more laid back in the insect kingdom, but it's just as ugly, if not more. Giant water bugs, for example, has the female devour the eggs any male is brooding over, so they become free to mate them. Not that it's any business of ours. We're more concerned about the insane number of kills insects carry out on a yearly basis. Assassin bugs, for example, kill 10,000 people a year. And no, that name is not an exaggeration. Assassin bugs, much like the baboons we saw in the last video, lie in wait. They observe. They stalk. And once the prey has been found, it's lock and load time. Escape is close to impossible. The bug catches the prey and pierces it with a stinger, paralyzing it. The good news is, they're fairly easy to spot. Bright red with narrow necks, curved appendages, and sturdy builds. Way easier than trying to find a hippo underwater. But snakes, the slithery, sneaky things they are, beat assassin bugs by 40,000 people. That number is based on reported deaths, emphasis on the word reported. It's gotten so bad that the World Health Organization funded $136.7 million into educating affected communities about how to prevent snake bites and treat bites to stop the spread of venom. But none of these animals hold a candle to humans. We undoubtedly cause the most amount of damage to ourselves. From war to murder, despite being one of the most intelligent species, we always go back to the primitive act of attacking our kind. But don't worry, we definitely aren't our biggest enemy. That honor goes to an insect we know all too well, the mosquito. Their numbers range from 700,000 to a million per year, and at least 700 million people contract diseases from these pesky little things. It's not the mosquito itself that kills, but a parasite the mosquito carries. The females of the Anopheles genus carry the malaria parasite, which they transmit when they bite an infected person and then one that's uninfected. Malaria is a blood-transmitted disease, which means you can't contract it from casual contact with another person. And if that wasn't enough, they also carry the West Nile virus and dengue fever. West Nile is a disease insects pick up from infected birds. It affects the nervous system and, like malaria, can be very serious in people with weaker immune systems. Dengue fever causes a rash and extreme muscle and joint pain, and can be fatal if not treated properly. So forget lions, tigers, and bears. Turn your paranoia to the teeny tiny mosquito buzzing near your ear. Been wondering what happened to those 12 children on the boat in West Africa? The attack wasn't just a warning. The students, all aged around 12 to 13, died when the hippo flipped the boat over. The villager transporting them also died. This is one of the more upsetting stories and shows how far animals will go to defend their territory. If you're in a boat, make sure you give hippos plenty of space and don't go into rivers that have large numbers of them. And listen for oxpecker calls. It's often a warning sign that there's a hippo around. And last but not least, leave them alone.
Beck, Beck.
As their numbers decrease, it's natural for them to get desperate to defend their own and resort to violent measures. We have to remember that this is their home too. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button and check out more on our channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching.